Hi and welcome! In this tutorial, we will look at how to show a tooltip at mouse position when hovering over elements in our text box which got tagged with the link tag. We will be able to reuse some code from the previous tutorial. In that one, we had a look at how the link tag syntax is set up and additionally how to create a basic system of making our texts clickable by tagging certain parts of our text box's content with the link tag. Again, we will have three scripts: the tooltip handler, the link handler, and the tooltip infos. Let's start with the link handler. I copied the scripts from our previous handler into a new file and rename it to link handler for TMP text hover to distinguish both from one another. We'll get rid of the IPointer click handler and the corresponding onClick function. Instead, we'll need an update function for this. Why don't we simply use the IPointerEnter and exit interfaces? Well, those check the text boxes rather than the particularly linked tagged words or sprites. That way, we would need to leave the text box area before hovering over anything else, and that feels super clunky and unintuitive to me. We'll need to add a few more entries up here. First comes a reference to our text box's rect transform, so we can check if we are hovering above our text box in the first place. Additionally, we need a private int to save which linked element we are currently hovering over. Yes, this is an int, not a string. And lastly, we need to have an event that closes the tooltip when we are leaving the tagged word or sprite, since we won't be using the click-to-close way of manually closing the tooltip in this version. In Awake, add a get component to save a reference to our text box's rect transform component like this. Instead of adding everything directly to our update function, I'll create a new function. In my experience, this helps organizing the code a lot. The first thing we need to add to our new function is the position of the mouse cursor. In our click script, this could be read by using the pointer event data, but this time we are not as lucky and need to get it some other way that works with our input system of choice. Next, we'll need to check if we are hovering inside our text box, and if we don't, we can return without having to do anything. The isIntersectingRectTransform is part of text utilities and works perfectly for this scenario. You check if there is a link at a mouse position like this. If the value is not -1, which is the default if there is no link to be found at the position of the mouse cursor, we need to get the corresponding link info. In the previous tutorial, I had my tooltip pop up at the same position every time, no matter where I clicked on the text. In this version though, I want my tooltip to be placed slightly above my mouse cursor at the point where I hover above the linked element. Since we found a link, we'll need to notify the listeners to our event. Because our tooltip handler will have to know where to put the tooltip, we'll need to extend the delegate with the vector3 parameter up here, and we will add it to our invoke as well. We'll need to update which our currently active element is, so our tooltip system will behave as expected, because we still need to close our tooltip, don't we? We check if the current linked element is the same as the intersecting word, and if it's not, we'll notify the listeners. This time, we are going to use the GetLinkID instead of GetLinkText. This will keep our system much more flexible. Think about a system where you permit your players to name the characters in a party, for example. A static system could get away with a link tag like this, but if the characters can be renamed, this makes a lot more sense. Our tooltipInfo struct will simply be expanded to include a string for a description. Our tooltip handler stays almost the same as well. We'll need to add our two new events to onEnable and onDisable to be able to listen to them, and this time our closed tooltip will be hooked up in the same system as well. GetTooltipInfo will now additionally need the mouse position as a parameter, and we need it to our function like this inside the second if statement. I am additionally adding a Y offset of 300 to have the tooltip be displayed above my mouse cursor. Luckily for this tutorial, I won't run into any edge cases, so I can ignore those for now. Your value might look different depending on the size of your tooltip box. Instead of displaying the keyword, we will of course be displaying the description instead. Give your system a try! In the next tutorial, we will have a look at how to create a simple typewriter effect. In the video after that, we will use it to start using link tags as markers for sending events in a dialog system. I'll hope to see you there! If you liked the video, please like the video and subscribe to get notified about my new tutorials. You would make my day. Oh, and I started uploading my tutorial scripts to GitHub, so you'll find the link in the video description below too. I hope you have a great week.